Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to show you how to improve audio quality in CapCut PC. So if you want to improve your noisy audio quality on CapCut PC, this video is going to help you out. We're going to be exploiting some of CapCut's free and pro features for your audio recording. And if you watch till the end, I'll show you a free tool you can use to improve your audio quality if you're not using CapCut Pro. So the first thing you want to do is import your audio or your video onto your timeline. Once on your timeline, if it's a video, when you click on it, you'll be able to customize the video settings, audio, speed, animations, adjustments, and many more. Click on audio and you can improve the audio quality from here. If it's a video and audio that are detached, click on the audio. So come to the basic section. You can increase the audio volume in this section if the audio is too down. With the normalized loudness, you'll be able to normalize the original loudness of the selected clip. This makes your audio more audible. So in this video, we're going to be editing this audio and try to make it sound more professional. This is what it currently sounds like.
This is a test recording for how to improve audio quality on CapCut PC.
Now, there are also other features such as the enhanced voice, but this is a pro feature. To enable this feature, click on the radio. This is what it currently sounds like.
This is a test recording for how to improve audio quality on CapCut PC.
There's still a little bit of noise in the background. You can click on reduce noise and that will help you reduce the noise. But one of the features that I found most useful on CapCut is the vocal isolation. Now when you click on vocal isolation, there will be more improvement to your audio. And this is what it currently sounds like with the vocal isolation.
This is a test recording for how to improve audio quality on CapCut PC.
Now you can make any adjustment to your audio volume and customize it however you want. Once you're done with all the necessary changes, the next step is to export. Now when you choose to export your video, if you're not using a CapCut Pro account, you won't be able to export your videos unless you remove the pro features that you're using on your video. Now if that is your challenge, this is what you can do to improve your audio quality. So for the next step, we'll need only the audio file. So if you have a video on your timeline, you can remove all the pro features from your video and export only the audio. And click on export. And you want to export only the audio. Click on audio only and click on export. Once exported, now go to your browser and search for Adobe Podcast. Click on the option with podcast.adobe.com and sign up for an account. Now scroll down a little to the bottom and you see enhanced speech. Click on go to enhance speech. This will allow you to upload and enhance your speech. But if you want pro customization, search for my edit. Click on the link with myedit.online. Click on audio. And you have access to pro features such as vocal isolation, audio denoise, wind remover, speech enhancer, and many more. Click on audio denoise and add your file here. With this, you can use all the features for free, but you're only limited to just having one download in a day. This will automatically remove any noise, and this is what it sounds like.
This is a test recording for how to improve audio quality on CapCut PC.
This sounds better, so scroll down a little. You can increase the noise reduction level and compensation. Now, if you find multiple issues with your audio, you can switch between any of the features. When you are done with all the edits, click on download and click continue to download. Now, once you're done, drag your new file onto your timeline, right click to extract the old audio and delete it from your timeline. So thank you for watching this video on how to improve audio quality in CapCut PC, and I hope you found this video helpful. If you do find this video helpful, do make sure to like, subscribe, and have the post notification turned on.